Hello everyone, welcome back. Let's continue the topic nutrition in plant. Okay, so in the last classes we just dealt with autotrophic nutrition, right? So as we are dealing with modes of nutrition, already we dealt with autotrophic nutrition, right? So here auto means self, whereas tropho means nourishment. Okay, plant prepare their own food in presence of sunlight and chlorophyll by using carbon dioxide and water, and gives rise to carbohydrate and oxygen. Yes, this is what we have learnt till now, right? Autotrophic mode of nutrition means plant prepare their own food here. They won't depend on others for their food. Okay. So, whereas in this now video clipping, we are going to deal with those organisms which depend on others for their nutrition. That is what we are going to deal with today. Okay. So, what we call it as heterotrophic nutrition. Hetero means, let me write this side, other. Okay, trophos means nourishment. So here organism depend on others for their nutrition, okay, for their food, right? So those organisms are called as heterotrophs. Okay, so what are those now? Let's deal with it in this video clip. So let's deal with heterotrophic mode of nutrition. What happens in this is organism completely depend on other for their food. They take ready-made food which is prepared by autotrophs. Okay, now can you just see the yellow color structure over this tree, branch of this tree and stem of this tree? Yes, this yellow color wiry structure is there, no, which is climbing this plant. It is cuscuta plant. What is it? Cuscuta plant. It cannot prepare its own food. It completely derive food from the plant on which it is climbing. See, dear children, cuscuta plant or amarbel it is called as. It cannot prepare its own food. It completely derives its nutrition from the plant on which it is climbing. Okay. So, the plant on which it is climbing is called as host. Okay. And cuscuta now it is called as parasite. Why we call it as parasite? Because it completely depends on the host plant for its nutrition. Okay. So, parasite. Which plant is parasite over here now? Cuscuta. Okay. And what is the host here? The host is the one which fulfills the nutrition of the parasite. Okay. So children, there are some plants which trap the insect to fulfill their nutrition. Can you imagine plant trapping insect to fulfill their nutrition? Yes, of course you can have a look over here. The picture shows it. How does pitcher plant traps the insect to fulfill its nutrition? So look at the picture, children. Here pitcher like or jug like structure is there, no? This is modified form of leaf. Okay, and the apex part of the leaf is modified into lid. What happens here? As the insect, okay, sits over the pitcher, this lid closes immediately. Okay, so this insect slips into the pitcher, and what happens inside the pitcher? There is hairy like projection or structure. This entangles the insect and kills it inside as by the juice which is secreted inside. Okay, and after that nutrients from this insect is absorbed by the pitcher. This is how nutrition will be fulfilled. Okay, so this plant, insectivorous plant, fulfills its nutrients in this form. Okay, as the photosynthesis of process also take place in this plant, but the thing is it grows in swamp areas where there is lack of nitrogen. Okay, so less amount of nitrogen this plant gets over there in those areas. So to fulfill that nitrogen, that lack of nitrogen, what does this pitcher plant do? It traps the insect to fulfill that nitrogen mineral. Okay, so this is how it fulfills its nutrition. So these kind of plants are called as insectivorous plant. Okay, another example is Venus fly trap. Okay, this plant also fulfills its nutrition by trapping the insect. Okay, let's move on to another type of mode of nutrition, that is saprotrophic mode of nutrition. What happens in this? Saprotrophs completely depend on dead and decaying matter for their nutrients to be fulfilled. Means they derive the nutrients from the dead and decaying matter. Have you seen fluffy umbrella like structure which is grown in moist soil or rotting wood? Have you seen this growth, umbrella like structure, which is called as mushroom? Yes, of course. These mushrooms are saprotrophs because they depend completely on dead and decaying matter for their nutrients to be fulfilled. Okay, so here one activity is given in your textbook. What we need to do here is activity number 1.2. What we need to do here is we need to take bread slice, okay, and then moist it out, little means sprinkle water, and keep it aside for 2 to 3 days. Okay, after 2 to 3 days, you just observe in the microscope or use magnifying glasses. You just find over there thread-like structures on it. Okay, so those thread-like structures are none other than fungi. Okay, so these fungus, development or growth of this fungus is due to moist area or moist bread. Right, so where does this fungus grows? Where there is moist. Right, now how to avoid growth of this fungus then? You might have seen fungus grow on the pickle, leather which is moist for long time, or else clothes. Okay, so where there is moist, we find the growth of fungus, we can say. Actually, spores of these fungus will be in the air, and wherever it find moist area or moist things over it, it just falls and start germination. Okay, it just start germinating, it grows, it develops. Okay, so there we find the growth of fungus. So how can we avoid it? Yes, of course we can avoid it by keeping the area or things moist free. Okay, now the thing is, are all the fungi are harmful to us, harmful to plants? No, not at all. There are some fungi which are useful for us. Okay, and there are some fungi which are harmful also. Fine. So let's move on to another type of mode of nutrition, that is symbiotic mode of nutrition. What happens here in symbiosis? Some organism live together and share shelter and nutrients. Yes, what happens is here sharing and caring take place. Okay, for example, some fungus live in the root of the plant, okay, and provide nutrients to the plant. In turn, okay, in return, plant also provide nutrients to the fungi, as well as it provides a shelter to that fungus. So this is what is going on here, sharing, okay, nutrients as well as the shelter. So they live together. This is called as symbiotic type of nutrition or mode of nutrition. Okay, another example for the symbiosis mode of nutrition is lichens, in which alga and fungi live together. Okay, so fungi it gives shelter, water and mineral to the alga. In return, alga prepares and provide food to the fungi. Okay, so sharing is taking place here. So this is symbiotic mode of nutrition. Okay, so what all we have studied is autotrophic mode of nutrition. They prepare their own food. They won't depend on others. Okay, now here heterotrophic mode of nutrition, they depend on others for their food or nutrients to be fulfilled. In this we have studied parasitic mode of nutrition. What happens here is, actually parasite completely depend on the host plant for their nutrients to be fulfilled, or on which it grows. Okay, it derives the nutrient from that host plant. Okay, insectivorous, they trap the insect and fulfill its lack of nutrients, we can say. Actually, though it carries out the photosynthesis process, it is heterotroph, because where it grows in swamp areas, okay, where there is lack of nitrogen, less amount of nitrogen it gets. So to fulfill that lack of nitrogen, it traps the insect. Okay, so insectivorous plants, those are called as. Then here saprotrophic mode of nutrition. What happens here is plant completely depend on dead and decaying matter for their food to be fulfilled or nutrients to be fulfilled. Symbiosis, care and share, live together and share with each other. Okay, so here shelter as well as nutrients will be shared with each other. So this is what we have studied in this video clipping: parasitic mode of nutrition, insectivorous, saprotrophic as well as symbiosis. Let's come to the last part of the lesson, that is how nutrients are replenished in the soil. See here, what happens? So plant prepare its own food, okay, by absorbing nutrients from the soil. Roots absorb the nutrients from the soil, right? So the thing is, as roots are continuously absorbing the nutrients from the soil, so this declining of nutrients from the soil take place. How it is to be refilled or replenished now? Have you seen farmers adding fertilizers or manure to the soil? These fertilizer or manure contain nutrients such as nitrogen, potassium as well as phosphorus, etc., right? So as we know, there is abundant amount of nitrogen in the atmosphere, but plant cannot use it as it is using carbon dioxide. It can absorb it, but it cannot absorb this nitrogenous gas. It has to be converted to the soluble form, right? So there is bacterium called rhizobium. It converts this atmospheric nitrogen into soluble form or usable form, and this nitrogen is utilized by the plant. Whereas this rhizobium cannot prepare its own food, right? So what the rhizobium is doing over here, it is converting gaseous nitrogen into soluble form or usable form, and roots are absorbing that nitrogen. And in turn, this plant, legume plant, is providing shelter to the rhizobium as well as food to the rhizobium. Okay, so this is what here, which type of mode of nutrition is going on? Symbiosis. Okay, so sharing each other and helping each other, we can say caring each other, right? These rhizobium bacterium lives in gram, peas, mung, beans and other legumes, okay, and provide the nutrition to that plant. In turn, plant provide the shelter to it and food to it, right? So this symbiosis relationship is really significant, beneficial. So what we can say is rhizobium bacterium can reduce the usage of nitrogenous fertilizer where leguminous plants are grown. Okay, and we know that most of the pulses are obtained from leguminous plant only, right? So what we have learnt in this overall chapter is most of the plants are autotrophic, few are heterotrophic. So what we have studied in heterotrophic mode of nutrition is parasitic mode of nutrition, symbiotic mode of nutrition, saprotrophic mode of nutrition as well as insectivorous. Okay, so insectivorous, we can consider it as partial heterotrophic, because though photosynthesis process take place in this plant, okay, as they grow in swamp area where there is lack of nitrogen, which is required for the plant to be healthy. So how it get fulfilled? By trapping the insect. Okay, so partial heterotrophic we can call it as. Fine. So this is what we have learned in this lesson. I hope the concept of nutrition in plants is clear to you all. So until I upload next video clipping, please stay home, stay safe, and stay healthy.